So this is the final then of the under 18 European Championship. Serbia against Spain. As we look at our officials there, Markovic and Santa from Italy, Marek Cienkiewicz from Poland, and Petros Papapetru from Greece. And this final, as we look at the Serbia coach Marko Ćićević, brings back memories, of course, of the 2009 Eurobasket final in Katowice. Once again, it's Spain and Serbia on Polish soil, just as it was in that match 2 years ago. This, of course, though, the under 18 European Championship. Spain, led by Luis Gil, are looking for their third European under 18 gold medal. They won this competition in 1998 and 2004. They are the only team to have won every match they've played so far in the championship this year. Absolutely incredible record. Spain have beaten Czech Republic, Latvia, France, Russia, Italy, Lithuania, the defending champions, and Turkey. 7 wins out of 7. Serbia have only lost one of their 7 matches. That was against Turkey. But they have beaten Finland, Germany, Slovenia, Poland, France, and Italy. So we're underway, and I think the key thing here is, can Serbia stop Spain from playing? Because Spain have been absolutely outstanding. They've had several of the outstanding players of the tournament. But Serbia have, in places, really grown as the competition has gone on. We're looking here at Serbia on the attack with Vasily Micic, who's one of those players who has really grown. He's come through, scored some important points. Hernan Gomez with the foul on Micic. Gubic. Travelling given against Dan Gubic. Put his hand under the ball there. Interesting to see Micic there putting pressure on. Dieth has been one of the outstanding players, if not the outstanding player. Some of his statistics absolutely so impressive. Shot there from Sants. Away comes Serbia. Just about kept it in. Serbia pick up the first score. Popovski, Turanjanin, Hernan Gomez, Sants, Fernandez. Well, the rebound is gobbled up by Hernan Gomez. Fernandez, incidentally, who went for the layup there, the top scorer in the competition, going into the final day with 109 points. Miskovic with the score there. That's quite a frantic start. Great steal. Popovski worked it out wide nicely here. Serbia. Popovski got up to it, but Dieth with a foul. Dieth, fantastic statistics, not just in terms of scoring, but rebounds as well. Several double-doubles from him. Iskovic. Shot comes from Micić. Out it comes. Fernandez. The top scorer, as I mentioned, Fernandez. Although there are three players with over 100 points in the Spain squad. Fernandez, also Alejandro Abrines, and Daniel Díez. Here is Díez. Fernandez. Oh, slip. And Abrines takes full advantage. Didn't see who went over there. Micić. Crowded out. Díez. And Gubic with the foul for Serbia. Marko Ćirić there, guiding the Serbia team. And look at Micić, just not giving Jorge Sanz room to dribble forward. Here is Sanz. And then Gomez manages to score. And he gets the foul. Miskovic, the guilty party. And then Gomez adding another one from the free throw line. So a 3-point lead for Spain. You have to say that is going with form. Good work by Micić. Popovski. Good work from Popovski. Miskovic. Involved once again. Second foul for him. Dorde Milosevic clearly saying to Miskovic, there's no need for that. Here's the Popovski score. And Díez scoring again. Well, are Serbia thinking about ways to stop Spain doing exactly what they want? Jaime Fernandez kept it in. Sanz. Oh, he's missed it. Micić. Jeff didn't bring it away. Just about held on to. And Gubic, great drive, but he didn't score. Díez. Abrines. Shot didn't make it. It was from Sanz. Micić. And this time, Serbia do score. Dorde Milosevic. Jaime Fernandez. Díez. Worked the space well. Didn't manage to score. It's a really energetic start. Jorge Sanz with the foul here. Claudia Zola joining in. Milosevic foul by the Serbian. So I think we're yet to see the really key man for Serbia, Nenad Miljanovic. And the reason why I say it, I think he could be the key man, is he has been growing into the tournament. That's Popovski. His first foul. Miljanovic in the last few games has really started to stamp his authority on things, pick up lots of points. He wasn't doing that in the early stages of the championship. Sants. Now Brunez. Oh, great dribbling. Oh, that was a wonderful piece of skill. Gubic, absolutely bewildered, I think. I mean, it's just a sign that Spain are able to express themselves. There's a bit of freedom about the way they play. Two free throws converted by Abrines. And here he comes. This is Nenad Miljanovic. Miljanovic has got 91 points in the competition before this game. In the last two games, he scored 15 against France, 20 against Italy. Popovski scoring there. Sants. Miljanovic. What can he do? Can he change the way Serbia play at all? Eventually it worked its way in for Mitrovic. Shot with the left hand. Hernandez. 3-point opportunity. Missed. Field goals. As you can see, Spain taking four of them. Milosevic missing out. Here comes Sants. Fouled on his way through. Popovski with his second foul. Sands with a free throw. Takes the first. Not the second. Miljanovic. Oh, well played. Luka Mitrovic scoring, but it's quite right to give credit to Miljanovic as well. Great assist. Hernandez missing out. Certainly doesn't seem to be any fear about the way Spain are playing. I'm not worried about missing chances. comes back off the rim. Sants. Abrines. Gets the foul. Micić, the guilty party. Just something in Micić's eyes there that suggested that this is tougher than he thought. And he got two out of two. Last time he had free throws, Abrines. And he makes it four out of four. Great drive from Miljenovic, but I'll tell you what, Abrines stayed with him, crucially. Here comes Miljenovic again. He's missed again. Fernandez. Yes. Goes for the 3 points. Off the rim again. Both coaches, Luis Guil of Spain and Marko Ćićić, on their feet for Serbia. Milosevic. Micić draws the foul. Committed this time by Guillaume Vives. Is Saša Avramović. Miljenovic. He certainly changes the pace of the game for Serbia. Micić couldn't convert that one. Fernandez. It's tucked away by Olafeola. First quarter ends with Spain leading by 2 points. Serbia are only to their third win in 5 years. They did it in 2007 and 2009. Odd numbered years seem to favour them. Incidentally, it's worth mentioning that we haven't seen Nemanja Bezbradica for Serbia. He injured his left knee in the last minute of the second quarter against Italy. He didn't play for the rest of that semi-final. But equally, we haven't seen Nikola Jankovic yet for Serbia. Miljenovic. Chance there from Kristic. Abrines. Olesola. Oh, Dieth got behind Miljenovic too easily. He's a big man. It's impossible, surely, for him to go past unnoticed. Micić. 3 points. And it's there. Saša Avramović. Valenzuela. Now Brunez goes down. I think he collided with Krstić. It's Abramovich actually. He concedes the foul. Yes. Abrines makes it 3 points. Just starting to change gear, Spain. Micić. Goes up. Krstić it was who had the attempt. Well, Luis Buelli's animated Spain coach, that's one way of describing it. Abramovic colliding with Jose Perez. Yes. Well played by it. Spain there, held the ball. Perez. Miljanovic. Foul is against Perez on Miljanovic. Almost apologised. Spain seem to be concerned about Miljanovic. Abramovic. Oh, Miljanovic will pick it up. He hasn't scored again. Brilliant, brilliant work from Ole Zola. This is how Miljanovic picked the ball up. He's back to score. Oh, what a block by Ole Zola. Micić. Brilliantly worked by Micić, but Serbia don't manage to take advantage and they need to take those chances. These are points that are getting away from Serbia. Abrines. Arizona doesn't manage to score, but let's pick up the foul. Luka Mitrovic. Is it my imagination, or every time we look at the Serbians, are we seeing a team that feel they are struggling? Kovicic even shaking his head there. Much more confidence about the Spain players and coaching staff. Well, Ole Zola's another Spanish player with a 100% record from the free throw line in this game. Oh, good work from Micić. Serbia need to score here. Nicely followed up. Albert Homs. Oh, excuse me, it was Nikola Jankovic who scored. That is over again. The thick of things. And committing the foul. Arizona comes off. Hernan Gomez back in. Miljanovic. Handed off neatly. Converted by Jankovic. And he got the foul. Stojan Milosevic back up. And without Micić, there's a bit more room for Spain to bring the ball forward. Micić was working hard. This is Perez. Goes for 3 points and he makes it. Well, still haven't shaken Serbia off. Keeping their noses in front. Just bounced away for Dangubic. Jankovic there. Comes Krstić. And Gubic, you could see there, he was already in the action. Oh, a slip. Jankovic gets away with it. And Serbia pick up 3 points. Jankovic managed to recover. Get it out to Popovski. Perez. Popovski's really finding it difficult to stay with him. Milosevic gets it out to Popovski, goes for another 3 points. Doesn't make it this time. Popovski stopping sense. Third foul already. Sense. Pulled away. Miljanovic. Never got a man over Serbia there, even though they were on a fast attack. Oh, that's brilliant stuff from Vives. Foul is given against Milosevic. It was on sense. First foul against Milosevic. Krstić signaling the change. You see Luis Gil there in the background. Sants will have the free throws. Mišković comes in. Brines is 100% from the free throw line. Sants gets another one. Dangubic. Fernandez with the foul. Well, the fouls are totting up. Well, that was well played for Miskovic, but he couldn't make it count. And Spain do. Vives. Miljanovic. Oh, he's given his man the slip. Brilliant stuff for Miljanovic, and he gets the foul as well. Great bit of dribbling there. Gomez with the foul. Miljanovic adding the free throw. So there's his first scores of the match. Brunes is back in. Sense. Goes for 3 points. Didn't make it. It's still in. Miljanovic. Miskovic. Only 1 point in it. Great pass from Miljanovic. Vives. It's the foul. And he's come in and done well, Vives. Miskovic. Three fouls to his name. Seconds after scoring at the other end. Vives converts. Miljanovic. Up it goes. Well, the rebound is put away by Jankovic. In fact, it was Milosevic. First shot came in from Dangubic, and that's Milosevic who gets his hand to the rebound. Sants. Free scoring period at the moment. Miljanovic. Now he's finding his range. Some great basketball being played by these two teams. I feel it's taken Miljanovic a while to warm up, but he certainly has now. Dangubic there. Spain's ball with Abrines. Olazola. Sants. Out by Krstić. First one for him. Marko Ivicic won't want to be giving away too many free throws. Spain are clinical. When they get the free throws, they tend to take them. Jorge Sanz, look at that. 5 out of 6 he's got now. Marko Ivicic. he's given a talking to. Look at that, 13 of Spain's points have come from free throws. If you took the free throws out of the equation, Serbia would be a long way ahead. Now, of course, that's notwithstanding the fact that fouls are committed and points might have been scored, but I think the real key of that statistic is that if Spain are given free throws, they tend to make the most of them. Sanz driving forward. Olezola. And Dieth. They've got some big guys, Spain. They make the most of it. Milosevic. It's a three-pointer that came back. Sanz. Luis Gil, the Spain coach, is really pulling the strings. Even told Sanz to come to this side of the court. Didn't quite make that one, but he did pick up the foul. Kristic desperately trying to defend. To defend. Two fouls for him now. Well, back comes Micić. Mijanović is also on. So it'd be interesting to see how Serbia operate now, because when Micić was on earlier, he was putting the pressure on, trying to stop attacks before they really happen. And once Mijanović joined in, that didn't really happen for Serbia. Mijanović, he's a great dribbler. Micić. Everything's to his right. Here's a chance for 3 points. And it's taken brilliantly. Kristic. Well, interesting. Micić is backing off. He's not getting close. Mijanović is allowing Sanz to dribble where he likes in the Serbia court. And if anything, Sanz got by Mijanović there too easily to score for this. Mijanović just seemed to be caught flat-footed. Time out. Just a few seconds left in the quarter. The statistics there. Serbia have only taken 39% of their two-point attempts. 46% on 3 points. Spain much more reliable when they get within an easy shooting range. No real surprise that Serbia have had and scored more 3 points than Spain. Serbia are going to have to take their chances. But they can take inspiration from the bronze medal match, I think, because Turkey managed to win the bronze medal. They beat Italy, even though they were behind, but, well, about 38 of the 40 minutes of play. Serbia are certainly hanging on to Spain's coattails. That gap of 7 points is just about as wide as it's been. We're looking there at Alejandro Suarez. Mijenovic. Took the shot to nothing at the end of the second quarter. Mark Ijic doesn't even seem happy with the fact that Mijenovic went for a shot with a couple of seconds left. Feels he could have got closer maybe. But it's Spain then with a 7-point lead at the halfway stage. Going into the match, that is probably the sort of scoreline we would expect. Spain having won all seven of their matches leading up to this final. But can Serbia get organised and somehow cause a shock? Join us in a few moments for the third quarter. Thank you. Welcome back to the third quarter of this, the final of the European Under-18 Basketball Championship. Spain going into the second half of this game, leading by 7 points. Serbia really need to find a way to get organised if they are going to stop quite a free-moving Spain side. Spain is certainly able to express themselves. They don't seem to feel any fear. We're just looking at some of the Serbian players during the match so far. You get the feeling that they're a bit ruffled, but they are still within striking distance. Spain, of course, in the red strip. Serbia in white. And you can see there, only 2 points in it in the first quarter and five in the second. So this match is certainly not out of Serbia's reach, but Spain have been the better team, and that's what we would expect. Spain have won 7 matches in a row to get to this final. Serbia won 6 of their 7. The only team that beat Serbia on their way to the final were Turkey. For probably half of the first 2 quarters, Miljenovic playing for Serbia. The other half we saw Marko, or rather, the other half we saw Vasily Micic. There is Miljenovic. He's going to start the third quarter, clearly. Micic has struggled with turnovers at times in this tournament, so maybe that's why Miljenovic is going to be out there. Micic is starting the third quarter as well. Really looking in these early stages in the third quarter for signs that Serbia have either found a way to stop Spain playing their free-flowing game, or that they feel they can get organised and be more reliable on the attack. Ole Zola diving on the ball. Desperate sweep away by Jorge Sanz. Bit of resting afterwards from Mitrovic. Miljenovic will have the ball for Serbia. And it's Micic. Sanz, he's got two to his left. 3-on-2 for a moment there, but Sanz decided to keep the ball. Hernandez. And Serbia all cut out by Sanz. Micic is trying to bounce it through. Sanz once more. Hernandez. Goes for 3 points. Off the rim. Micic, Miljenovic. Here's a chance. Not taken. Luka Micic it was who went for the 3 points. And then Jaime Fernandez with the foul. As Jure Milosevic tried to pick up the rebound. He's clearly unhappy. Vives is on. Once again, it's Mitrovic. Mijenovic. Mitrovic goes driving forward and he gets it. The gap is down to 5 points. Sants. This is Vives. Yes. Didn't quite pick that one up. Oh, well played by Micić. Oh, what a wonderful dribble. There are three players trailing in his wake here. Sants, Dieth and Vives. Olezola. Sants. Driving run from Sants. Mijenovic picks up the rebound. Micić to his right. There's a block though. Zagrinis with his first foul. Both Micić and Mijenovic, as I say, out on court. For Serbia. Mitrovic, only 1 point in it now. 6 points without reply from Serbia so far in the third quarter. Gave Olezola the slip. Sants. Olezola. Sants once more. And again, Serbia failed. Well, Serbia prevents Bain from scoring, but in the second attempt, Sands does. Still only one score in it. This final looks like it could go down to the wire. Mitrovic. And we went through a spell like this in the second quarter where both teams were scoring. I don't get the feeling that Luis Gil, the Spain coach, is too concerned about organisation for his team. He just knows he's got the players who can do things like that. Oh, Spain have got it back. Sants. 3 points, and that's a real bonus for Spain. Big mistake by Serbia. Sants with 5 points in a matter of seconds. And they were 3 points cheaply given up by Serbia. Micić. Foul is given against Olezola. Micić it was. Tried to bundle his way through. Mitrovic it was who went for the 3 points. Didn't make it. Still really close. Are Serbia going to find a way to take the gold medal from Spain? Vives. He's got it back. Given away. Mijenovic. He's got Micić with him. Milosevic driving forward. Foul is given against Dieth. And Milosevic will have the free throws. Spain have been much more reliable from the free throw line. That's another one Serbia have missed. And again. Olizola. Abrines. Sants. Dieth goes for 3 points. Olizola for the rebound. Still in court. Sants for three again. Well, Serbia survived. Sants is upset. Off goes Milosevic. Angubic. Back in. Micic. Still Serbia playing with both Micic and Mijenovic in court. Angubic. Oh, that's well played, but Micic is stopped by Olizola. It's a foul, though. What a pass from Popovski. And it looked like Olizola had made a good block, but foul is given against him. It's three fouls. I think I'm right in saying they've all been in the third quarter. In comes Hernan Gomez. Micic, surely Serbia aren't going to miss two more free throws, are they? No, they've scored one. And he makes it 2 out of 2 for his personal tally. Yes. Abrines. Hernan Gomez. Finishing things off. In fact, Hernan Gomez didn't touch it, did he? It was Abrines with the basket. Oh, what a run by Vives. Really picked up speed. Vives with the foul. So the gap is 6 points at the moment. It was 7 at the start of the quarter. More free throws. Popovski misses again. Is it the pressure? But he's taken that one. So 5 points in it. Look at that. 4 out of 8 free throws scored by Serbia. 15 out of 16 by Spain. Extraordinary difference. Abrines. Mijenovic with the rebound. Micic. I think he was a bit too clever for Jankovic. Popovski. And Sants. Catch up their differences. We're looking there at Nemanja Dangubic with his third foul. I wonder if things could have been different at all for Serbia if they had been able to call on Nemanja Bezbradica. Bezbradica, who hurt himself halfway through the semi-final against Italy. It's his left knee, hasn't been able to play in this one. That is why we have seen Nikola Jankovic play for Serbia. Jankovic to number 12, there's Vives. Dangubic to restart. Miljanovic. Chance for Popovski. Sands claiming the rebound. Yes. Sands. Sands goes for three. Didn't make it. Have another go maybe. No. Dangubic with the foul. That's his fourth. Kristic is in. Serbia is still hanging in there. That's Alejandro Suarez. You can see number 10 for Spain. Suarez. Vives. Sanz. Suarez. Keeping it alive, Spain. Sanz. Sanz shoots. Picked up though by Jankovic. And now Miljanovic. Change of direction for Miljanovic. And it's there. Back to 3 points. Sands. Cleverly done. Look at this. Ran into a position under the basket where all the Serbian players moved away from him. Micic. Micic. Got the second attempt. Last few seconds of the third quarter. Micic with his second foul. This one on Abrines. Perez. Still Perez. Miljanovic intercepting. We've still got it, Serbia. And somehow the ball squirmed away from Serbia there. Vives, I think, down. Yes, it is. But he's all right. Holding his shoulder. There is Nikola Jankovic, who had the foul on Vives. Gomez is taken out. Perez. And there is the hooter for the end of the third quarter. We're looking there at Alejandro Suarez. Spain will have a 3-point lead going into the final quarter of this gold medal match. Two countries aiming to win their third under-18 European Championship. And it could hardly be closer, could it? 3 points between these two teams. And the last chances for the cheerleaders to show their stuff. The really crucial action right now is taking place on the sidelines. Marko Kicinic, the Spain coach Luis Gil, trying to make the decisions and pass on the instructions that will seal gold medal for their team. Things have evened up in terms of the number of 2 point and 3 points taken. Can't help but look at the free throws. I'd say that Serbia missed some great chances for some points. 4 chances they've squandered on free throws. 4 points have gone away, but Serbia are actually top on rebounds. So the last period of the under-18 European Championship for 2011. Either Spain or Serbia are going to be crowned the winners in Wroclaw. Sounds with the first points of the fourth quarter. Popovski held up by Suarez. Popovski driving his way past the Spain number 10. Miljanovic now. Running out of time for a shot. Micić goes for it. Micić. Popovski and Mitrovic getting frustrated underneath the basket. Fernandez. Kristic with the foul this time. Three fouls for Kristic. Dangubic is in again. Fernandez. Zola lost control of the ball. Four fouls for Zola. As I mentioned before, they've all come in the second half of the match. Hernan Gomez is back in. Micić driving forward. 3-point chance for Miljanovic. Doesn't take it. Well, that could have made things interesting if Mijenovic had managed to score from there. Hernandez just about scrambling through. That goes Mitrovic. Dan Gubic it was there who first collided with Fernandez. Suarez. Sanz chance. Mijenovic now. Great run by Mijenovic. Stopped though quite brilliantly by Hernan Gomez. Number 12 you saw there was Nikola Jankovic, of course. But it was Mijenovic who had dribbled his way forward. Fernandez scores. That was a brilliant shot, reversing the layup. Micic. Mike goes for 3 points, comes back. Mijenovic with a foul. Foul on Fernandez. It was so crucial to Serbia getting to this final. Mijenovic. As I mentioned earlier, he scored 15 points against France, 20 against Italy. He hasn't quite shown that form so far. Jankovic with the foul. Free throw once again for Spain. Remember, they've scored 15 of the 16 they've taken so far. This time, the man who's shooting is Jaime Fernandez. That's 16 out of 17 now for Spain. And that is 17 out of 18. 17 of Spain's 60 points scored from the free throw line. Gubic. 3 points didn't make it. Suarez. Foul this time by Jankovic. He's getting frustrated. Time out. And right now Spain are accelerating towards the gold medal. Serbia need to find something to stop this red tide. They made a good start, Spain. But right now with the gold medal in their sights, now starting to put their feet down. Serbia won the third quarter by 15 points to 11. They closed the gap at that stage. Only 3 points in it going into this fourth quarter. Serbia haven't scored yet in this period. Spain can put that lack of Serbia points down to organisation or muscle, really. team. Five that have been out there for the last few minutes. Just enormous. Look at them. Brunes, Hernan Gomez, Suarez. In terms of rebounds, those players tend to pick them up. You look at the Serbia team at the moment, not quite so bulky. This is the 19th free throw for Spain in the match. It's only the second one they've missed. It's the first time they've missed two in a row. 17 out of 20 free throws scored by Spain. Jankovic. Travelling given against Jankovic. Hold on to it too long. Well, he's a big man, Jankovic, and he was in the land of big men, had three huge Spanish players around him. Fernandez. Beaten away by Serbia. Micic. Serbia have got it back with Jankovic. Tried to power his way through. The foul. Jankovic. Well, he didn't make that one. Five out of nine Serbia have missed now. Five out of ten they've scored. 8 points separate the teams with 6 minutes left. Popovski back in, taking the place of Jankovic. Sants. Well, gave Dangubic a shove. So foul against Sants. That's two fouls from him. Dieth is back in. Well, it's a score for Mitrovic and a foul. Well, this is an important moment for Serbia. Suarez is in again. Gomez off on four fouls. Mitrovic with the 11th free throw for Serbia. The sixth one they've taken. And I think Lewis Gwilt just had a look at the scoreboard. 5 points separate the teams. 5 minutes to go. Fernandez. Back off the rim. Micic. Micic turning on the afterburners. And the foul is given. It's given against Fernandez. Serbia are starting to put their feet down and accelerate. They're going for it. timeout. Spain players are really using the timeout for a rest. No sign of Lewis Gil overloading his players with information. Now he's going to pass on what he needs to. Marko Ćićić taking the opportunity. His message across could be this one piece of advice or organisation could help Serbia overturn this lead that Spain have. Have to say, credit to Serbia because they pushed the Spain team hard. A number of fouls. Hernan Gomez, Fernandez and Olazola, all on four each. Two free throws for Ćićić. Serbia really need these. Ćićić taking the second of those chances. So it's 4 points now between the teams. Vives. Here he goes again, Vives. Oh, it's a good block. Piet with the rebound and he puts it away. Well, that was crucial for Spain. Ćićić tells Milosevic to get inside the 3-point line. That's a great layup from Ćićić. Well, single-handedly he's trying to drag Serbia back into this. Still only 4 points the difference. Dieth, Brunes, and now Vives. Dieff driving forward once more, comes back, Popovski. Ćićić once more. They can level things up or take the lead in the next couple of minutes. Dangubic, oh, off the rim. Gold medal could go to either of these teams still. Sands. Shot clock's running down. This is with the three-pointer. Ćićić. He's got two players wide on the left. Looking for 3 points. And Olazola with his fifth foul. Well, they've all come in the second half. Well, does that help Serbia in any way? Is running out anyway, of course. Ćićić takes this free throw. Now he has a chance to cut the gap to 2 points. Game on. Back comes Miljanovic. And Serbia sense their chance, I think. Sense. Fernandez. Remember, Spain have won all seven of their matches in this under 18 European Championship up to this point. Miljanovic didn't manage to keep the ball in court there. Serbia have only lost one of their seven games up to this point. Fernandez. And the top scorer in the competition, as to his talent. And there's a block by Abrines. Away comes Spain. Fernandez, happy to wait to the end of the shot clock. Nowhere near. Miljanovic. Angubic. Micic. Oh, he's got past Dietar. It's absolutely brilliant. And Micic is single-handedly dragging Serbia back into this. Serbia win the gold medal, they'll owe a huge debt to Micic. Fernandez. Foul is given against Popovski. He's on four fouls now. Well, shouldn't make too much difference. We're in the last minute. But Suarez now has two free throws. Serbia, 3 points behind, only one score in it, but this free throw could change that. And it does. And not surprisingly, we're going to have a timeout with 59 seconds left. Serbia need to find something special at the end. Otherwise, Spain are going to be the under 18 European champions for the third time. Vucinic with his orders. Time to listen. This is the time for the team to work together. Because if they can, the prize on offer is huge. Here's Bill. Seems to be passing on advice about defending. As far as he's concerned, it's about keeping Serbia out, maybe for two attacks. Running the clock down when they get the ball. The under 18 European Championship boils down to this last minute of play in the final between Spain and Serbia. Spain leading by 4 points. And they are the favourites to win the title. Micic. Serbia need to score on this attack, really. Micić gets it out wide. Popovski goes for 3 points. It's blocked, but there's a foul. Suarez. Well, the one thing in Spain's favour here is that Serbia don't tend to score their free throws. And these are going to Luka Mitrovic. He knew he'd missed as soon as the ball left his hands. But if he can take this chance, they'll be within a score. And he hasn't. They've got to score two baskets, Serbia. And no wonder Mitrovic has lifted his jersey over his head. Vives coming on. Off goes Popovski. Five fouls from him now. That's the end of his European Championship. And Abrines now with two free throws that will surely guarantee Spain the gold medal. Five out of five for him so far, as you can see. He makes it six out of six. But he doesn't. It would have been a 6 point gap. It's five. Serbia still have to score twice. Micić, Dangubic goes for 3 points. And it's back off the rim. That must be the end of Serbia's chances. Maybe 7 seconds left. Serbia will have the ball again. But before they get it, they will face two free throws from Sants. Jorge Sants, this will make it three basket difference. That's exactly what happens. And we have a timeout, but there is no time, surely, well, not enough time for Serbia to score three times. So Spain are going to be the under-18 European champions for the third time. Haven't won the title since 2004, and frankly, Lewis Gwilt would just as well be choreographing the victory celebrations here rather than giving out advice on how to play out the last few seconds. How about that for a statistic? 10 block shots by Spain. And I have to say, I don't have the statistics to my fingertips, but players who have been involved in making those blocks, I think, are Daniel Díez, Alejandro Suarez, and Julen Olazola. They are the huge players that have made a difference for Spain. It also offers so much in attack as well. Micić, even though he told his players what to go out and do, he must be resigned to defeat. Lewis Gwil is about to celebrate with his Spain team, becoming under-18 European champion. Serbia put up a great, great fight. Jaime Fernandez with a foul. End of the game for him. Miljanovic two free throws. And even if he takes them, and there's no guarantee of that, Serbia will need two more baskets. Rebound picked up by Abrines. Now the foul by Saša Avramović. So it will be Vives. No, it won't. It's Abrines, sorry. Free throws for Spain. I'm afraid all these free throws at the end are just making the complexion of the scoreline more favourable to Spain. Serbia have played well. It's been a closer match probably than the scoreline suggests in this fourth quarter anyway. But it's impossible to take any credit away from Spain. They have been the outstanding team of the championship. They've been the better team in this final. Milenovic with a chance to make the scoreline a bit more respectable. Does take both free throws. Timeout again. Well, is there a slim chance? Surely not. It would be incredible if Serbia were to do anything from here, but there are only 11 seconds left. The real problem that Lewis Gwil has here, I suppose, is trying to work out how to get the ball in play and keep it in play to run the clock down. Obviously, Serbia will try and stop the clock in some way. Well, I think we're looking at the silver medalists. Milenovic with the foul. Well, they've stopped the clock again. And it's another miss. They go straight down with Milenovic. Dangubic. He missed it. And that's it. Spain are the victors by 71 points to 65 in the final. They are the under-18 European champions for the third time. It's the first time they've won the gold medal since 2004. Well, they have been the outstanding team of the championship. That's 8 wins in a row now for Spain. Bitter disappointment for Serbia, who deserve to have made it to the final, and they pushed Spain hard. for long periods.